a rosed lipstick, a blonde hair reversed the peaceful and happy life of Dr. Gemma Foster. In everyone's eyes, Gemma has everything that others admire. She does a job that makes others respect, a happy family. She has a husband who loves her, an obedient son. She felt everything perfect. Until one day, Gemma brought clothes to wash, then she discovered some coins in her husband's pocket with a lipstick. Gemma's husband Simon said he used the lipstick because his lips were too dry. Gemma teased him as feminine. After the family finished breakfast, Gemma was about to go to work and could not see her scarf. Simon gave his scarf to her. Upon arriving at the hospital, a blonde hair on a scarf caught Gemma's attention. She felt a little suspicious. However, since it was time to work, she could only continue with her work. This woman is Carrie. Because of insomnia, she wanted to ask Gemma to prescribe the sleeping pills for her, but Gemma refused. A patient named Seuss wanted to thank Gemma, so she invited her to her restaurant grand opening party. Gemma examined the blonde hair on her husband's scarf. Speculations began to arise in her mind. In the afternoon when she went to pick up her son, Gemma was called by a woman. The woman introduces her name as Becky. She is Simon's assistant. Later, Gemma learned that Becky had just got divorced. She raised her daughter alone. Furthermore, her hair is blonde. Even more important, Gemma knew that her husband gets off work at 5 o'clock every day. But in fact, her husband comes home every day at 7 o'clock. Gemma confided in her colleague Rose, who was also her best friend, about her husband's affair. Rose said that Gemma was thinking too much. At 4:30, Gemma told the staff that she had some business, so she would leave soon. Then she drove to Simon's company. Gemma calls her neighbor Anna to ask her to pick up her son. Gemma followed Simon's car. On the way, Simon stopped to buy a bouquet. That reminded Gemma of lipstick and blonde hair. Her tears are about to fall. After arriving, Gemma learned that Simon's destination was a nursing home. Simon's mother is there. After greeting her mother-in-law, Gemma told Simon to go out to talk. She told him her doubts and how she followed him. Simon says he comes here every day because his mother's health is getting weaker. So is all this a misunderstanding? Is it the truth? When Gemma signed her signature on the hospital access log, something suddenly appeared in her mind. She returned to the reception to examine the daily schedule of the people who came to the hospital. She asked the receptionist if everyone who came here had to sign. The receptionist said it was their policy, so everyone has to do that. Gemma was in the car and watched Simon through the window. Gemma decided to investigate the truth. She went to Simon's office, investigating his daily schedule from his computer. In the evening, Gemma's family went to Seuss's for dinner together. Seuss introduced her husband Chris to everyone, as well as her son Andrew and daughter Kate. During the meal, Gemma told everyone that her house will operate a party tomorrow, and invites everyone to attend. Because tomorrow is Simon's 40th birthday. Seeing the intimate gestures of Seuss and Simon, she got up and went out. Gemma reunites with black woman Carrie. Carrie works at a nearby bar. After talking together, Gemma shared with Carrie about the problems she had recently encountered. She insisted that Simon had an affair. Carrie said that, if there is no evidence, nothing should be confirmed. That night, when Simon was sound asleep, Gemma woke up to search on the internet for information related to the investigation of the husband's affair. The next morning, Gemma made an appointment with Carrie to come to her clinic. Gemma agrees to prescribe sleeping pills for Carrie on the condition that Carrie help her follow Simon. Carrie followed Simon to a suburban residence. Simon took out a bag from the trunk and went inside a house. Gemma was examining the patient, then she received messages from Carrie that Simon had entered a house in Stubborn. Half an hour later, Carrie called to inform Gemma that Simon and a young woman were saying goodbye. Gemma wants Carrie to take the picture of them, but Carrie says she is quite far away from them. Gemma was extremely panicked with the information just got. Carrie says she can find the owner information from the license plate. Gemma took her son home and saw Carrie waiting there. Carrie says that the car's owner is Seuss. Gemma was amazed. She handed the medicine to Carrie and learned that Simon had pulled a bag out of the trunk of the car. Carrie said if Gemma wants to find proof, she should look for that bag. Gemma took her son to Simon's birthday party. As she walked, she took off one of her earrings. Gemma tells Simon that she wanted to borrow the car's keys because she just lost one of the earrings. She guessed it dropped in Simon's car, so she tried to persuade him to lend the car keys. Simon says she should come back quickly. Just then, the Seuss family also arrived there. Gemma searched the car but found nothing. When she wanted to give up, she suddenly thought of something. She opened the trunk and found a bag beside the spare tire. It contained a wallet, a bank card. Later, Gemma saw a phone with the background image of Simon and a young woman. That woman is Susus's daughter, Kate. She opened the photo album on the phone and saw a picture of Becky, the neighbor Anna. She also discovered the message of her best friend Rose with a content that reminded Simon to be careful because Gemma had doubted him. Gemma felt unbelievable. She tried to calm down. She put everything back to its original position. She then took a scissor from her car. She put it in her coat pocket and put on her earrings, adjusted her hair. She went back to the party. Gemma coldly looked at the fake faces of those close to her. At that moment, Simon's negligence caused him to burn. Gemma helped Simon handle the wound. After Simon finished blowing out the candles, he began to speak. Simon said his gratitude to two people who were so important in his life. The first one is his son, Tom. The boy is always obedient, so he did not have to worry much about him. The remaining person is Gemma, his beloved wife. He began to praise Gemma with fancy words. Gemma listened to those words with a cold face. They all raised glasses to congratulate the couple. Everyone waited for Gemma to speak. Do you want to know what happens next? Thank you for watching. Follow my page to watch more film review.